Hi, it's Michael Senoff here with Michael Senoff's HardToFindSeminars.com. Here's a very special interview. The title of this interview is called How I Made More Than $1 Million Online. It's an interview with internet consultant Terry Dean. Terry Dean used to be a pizza delivery driver hoping for little more than $2 tips and good weather. Then the internet came along and through trial and error, he figured out how to make the most of it. Now he's made more than $1 million selling products online and he teaches others how to do it too. Terry admits his success didn't happen overnight. Although he was making a decent living off the internet in about 6 months, it took him almost 10 years to get to the level he is now. And in this audio, you'll hear how he did it. You'll also hear the best ways to build a list and why you should be more concerned with building relationships with your list than with the length of the list itself. You'll learn low-risk and low-cost advertising that works. You'll learn tests that will help you be absolutely certain you're building a business that's based on demand. You'll learn how to use social networking sites to build your business and which ones are really worth your time. You'll learn quick and easy ideas for repurposing your content for YouTube, blog posts, books, DVDs, and more. According to Terry Dean, one of the biggest mistakes you can make in the internet business is to try to find the easiest route to riches. This is a trap that can actually prevent you from making money because instead of sticking with a solid plan, you're wasting time bouncing from one hyped up idea to the next. Fortunately, all you have to do is follow good, sound business advice to make money online. And in this interview, that's exactly what you're going to hear. And for more information about Terry, go to his website called www.killermarketingcoach.com. That's killer, K-I-L-L-E-R, M-A-R-K-E-T-I-N-G-C-O-A-C-H.com. Now let's get going.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Waters with an interview from Michael Senoff's HardToFindSeminars.com. Welcome, Terry Dean, to the program. I've enjoyed looking at your website and learning about you and what you do. And one of the things that really gets to me is, you know, you often hear about a person that has no marketing experience, no business experience, and they made it big. And you wonder, maybe this is used as a marketing tool in itself. So my question is, did you really go from delivering pizzas to $1 million business, or is that just a way to catch people's attention?
I really did go from delivering pizzas to earning quite a bit more than $1 million online. But the funny thing with it is, I wouldn't want anybody to think that I did it all of a sudden, or I did it in 1 month, because that just isn't the case. And that's where a lot of times there's what I would say misconceptions about the internet and other businesses, is people think that it's like an instant overnight success. And I think every overnight success I've ever heard of is really like a 10-year success that you see happening in the background. You just don't see all the other stuff going on. But really, I did get to earning a good full-time income pretty quickly online, about 6 months. Within about 6 months of starting online, I was doing about $6,000-$7,000 a month.
And where did that ambition come from? You know, did you just deliver one too many pizzas? Or while you were delivering them, did you have this brainstorm, this great idea? What happened? What came over you?
Well, what really happened was I had tried a lot of different things to succeed in business before. I had tried doing several network marketing companies. My wife could attest to the fact that our basement was filled with some of the stuff from network marketing companies. I had tried to do some direct sales. I'd even tried to do some direct mail that I'd borrowed money off the credit card to do. And none of that really worked out for me. But at that time, and we were moving back all the way to 1996, and I heard the very first stories of a few people using this internet thing to become successful. And that was just something I said to myself inside, that I can do this. That's something that I know I can do. It kind of fits me. I was never really good at direct one-on-one selling, but I had a talent for writing, and I'm a pretty good writer. And so I said, I can probably do this. And I just got started online. We bought my first computer with the whole intention of trying to make the internet work. I mean, it was a Pentium 75. Way back then, which is a dinosaur. But I remember real clearly when we went in and bought that at Best Buy, the Pentium 75 computer special that they had for a computer and monitors, like $2,500 back then. But I got it and went online, started doing some research, seeing what people were doing, and picked up some licenses to, like, self-help videos. We were doing VHS videos back then, and licensed those so I could sell them personally, and started selling those online. And that's where I really got started.
Where did you hear about the internet?
Well, I don't remember the first time I ever actually heard about the internet. I don't remember exactly where I first heard it, but I heard it was like maybe a news story that I watched or maybe a magazine article, but I heard that there were some people who were getting it to work, and something inside me said that this is something that I could do, and this is what is for me. And so to get started doing it, it's kind of funny, when I started back then, there was like nothing to teach you what to do online. I mean, it was just barely getting started, so there was nothing out there. So once I got on the internet, I went out and I bought some materials, like materials that Jay Abraham had, and other direct marketers who did like direct mail marketing, and I kept thinking to myself, you know, reading through each thing that they produced, how does this apply to the internet? How could I use what they talk about here online?
People didn't even have websites then, so how did you actually start up a business, or did that come later down the line?
There were websites at the time, because we got a website set up not too long after I got started. We started off with like some ads on CompuServe. It was like the big one at the time, and I was using CompuServe to go into the internet. But there were websites around, but they weren't very good. I sometimes talk about our ugly websites that we had back then, which was basically just, you know, a plastered bunch of text that didn't even match, was pretty much what the website was.
You certainly didn't have shopping carts back then, et cetera, did you?
Oh, no, we didn't have shopping carts. We actually had to take orders off by the phone first. At the very beginning, there wasn't any automatic ordering. Man, life is so much easier today than it was then for this, but we had to take orders over the phone. Not necessarily that it was a good thing, but some people weren't as scared about credit card numbers online because there wasn't credit card fraud, so some people would still order like through email or something, which I definitely wouldn't recommend anybody doing today because you'd probably get it stolen since it's not secure. But the interesting thing back then is we had to go through a lot of work to do all, and a lot of it was by trial and error. I like to tell people that I really failed my way to success online. I found out everything that didn't work first.
Can you give some examples of things that didn't work that you first tried?
Well, here's the real funny thing. When I first tried it, like any time that I spent a lot of money on advertising, it did badly for me. And again, we'll go back to that very beginning. It's a little bit different today, but I remember real well when I first spent money for this person who was a really good designer to design a really nice looking page, and I had been using one of those ugly pages with graphics that were all over the place and didn't look right, okay, and then I had them design this really nice page, and we stopped getting sales with this nice web page. You know, today, it's nicer to have a little bit of design, but back then, I mean, we all had really slow modems, and so everything was slow to load, and most of the sites were really bad looking, so if you had something that was, like, really gorgeous looking, it took forever to load, and then it, like, stood out from everything else, and it just didn't sell. It stopped selling, so that was one of my first lessons, was I had my ugly web page, we switched it out to a really nice one, and we stopped making any money. Didn't take me long to switch that back, so that was a big mistake. Any other time that I've spent a lot of money on advertising coming into it, I almost always ended up losing the money. So it's kind of interesting, as we went along, later on I ended up developing a membership site, and the whole point of that membership site was to show ads that I used that worked and ones that I didn't. And anybody who was a part of it got to see the fact that probably more than half the ads I ran didn't work, which by that I mean they lost money. And I think really it gives people a good understanding that just because you're an expert at it, just because you're good at it, doesn't mean everything works. It's all by testing that we figure out what works and what doesn't in our online business. And it's kind of funny, you know, more than half the ads don't work. But then how do I make a successful business? Well, I just keep running the ones that do.
Let me ask you something. What was the initial business? Was it selling these videotapes? Was that the initial business that you were putting ads up for?
Yes. Well, the biggest growth for me, I was doing pretty good because, you know, we get some ads that work and some that weren't. The little ones using, like, CompuServe. I don't remember what CompuServe was charging us back then. They were charging us some little fees. I think some things were free, but some of them they charged little fees for. What really was the biggest thing for my business was a little bit later on that year when I figured out that building an email list was the key principle to earning a profit from the business. I had to build an email list and keep following up on these customers. I mean, at first, I kind of just made some sales, and we didn't do anything with people who bought. We didn't try to capture anybody who didn't buy, and we just made some sales and made some money that way. So the big breakthrough I had was figuring out, hey, if I give away something, I can get people to give me their email address, and then I can follow up on them.
What was the second thing that you had that you were offering?
So at that point in time, I was still offering videos of other videos that I had, and the breakthrough was figuring out that it was based off the email list. And I mean, you hear a lot of people talk about that today, that the money's in the list, which is partially true because the real money's in the relationship with a list, which is building a relationship with them by sending out content, giving them value, and being someone that they can trust with the email. But that was my big breakthrough, was figuring out that list was important, so I started working with email lists. Today, we use like autoresponder systems and things like that. Back then, we had to use software. And I remember originally, when I first started building an opt-in email list, we were using some of the software people used for spam. They were using spam software to send out all these email lists. But in the beginning, we didn't have any of the good tools we have today, so we had to use some of the same software.
What were some of the steps that you used to keep your list growing?
Well, with Lyft, the very first thing I did was every ad I started placing them for the Lyft first. I'm going to give you something free if you sign up for this.
Okay.
You give me your email address, I'm going to give you this freebie, like this free report. It was just something I gave online, like a basic text file in the very beginning. Now we use PDF files, but then it was like a basic text file. We give it to you for signing up, and then I can follow up, and then I can send multiple promotions. So I can promote this video, I can promote that video, and basically build my business by making multiple sales instead of just the individual one sale I made in the beginning. Now, with the affiliates, I would consider affiliates like a separate thing, because when I was starting, I don't remember having any affiliates until eventually when I wrote my own first product, and we're talking at least 2 or 3 years later for that. So I think it's like 2 more years later before I even had anything that was affiliates.
But is that correct, that when you have affiliates, that part of that motivation is to expand your list?
With affiliates, it really is. They'll help you expand your list. But probably the biggest motivation for me with affiliates is the fact that I now can generate sales without spending anything up front. I'm only paying them when we make sales. When I buy advertising, or like if I buy advertising on Google pay-per-click, I have to pay for the ad whether it makes me any money or not. With affiliates, I'm only going to pay them if they made me money. They get a share of the sales.
Do you share lists with affiliates? To tell you the truth, I'm ignorant about that fact.
No, you do not share your list with affiliates. You don't share your list with anybody. At times, you'll send out an email to your list telling them about possibly an affiliate program or telling them about somebody else that they can subscribe to, but you don't ever actually share your list with any other business.
What are some other assumptions you think that people have about selling on the Internet that may be myths?
Well, probably the biggest myth is all I have to do is put up my website and this product and we're going to make a lot of sales. That is such a big myth. More than anything, it really comes down to giving some value away, giving it away free. I mean, you'll hear some people talk about the fact that there's a statement out there called moving the free line. And what that statement basically means is that people are giving away more for free. They're giving more value up front before they sell something, and they're doing that to build a relationship with people first to make the sale, because we buy from those who we know, like, and trust. So we build those relationships with people before we offer them something to buy. And so one of the big myths people have is that they can just put up the site, sell this product, and they'll make a lot of sales. Or another big myth that's out there, probably the biggest myth comes around with people thinking that it's going to be so easy, or they're going to place this one ad and it's going to make them so much money. But as I mentioned already, the fact that with me, whenever I ran like a big ad or spent a lot of money on advertising, usually it did poorly for me. So I quickly developed into the attitude of doing little, small, low-risk advertising, where I'm spending maybe $100 or less on an ad, and then if it works, I keep building on it. So a myth that comes in here is some people think that you need a lot of money to start Internet business, and my experience with this has actually been the opposite. That if you have too much money coming into your Internet business and you are willing to spend too much money, you're just going to end up losing the majority of it. So for most people, I tell them to spend some time getting into study different materials and then come in with a low investment, test everything each step along the way. And what I mean by that is when we're testing each step along the way, many times before I want to pick a product to sell, even before I get to that point, a lot of times I want to do a survey of people where I might go to a forum, or I might like run a small ad on AdWords, and I'll run them to a survey page asking them what they're actually looking for before we look for a product or develop a product for them. So I'm talking about we go each step along the way, assuming we really don't know a ton ourselves, and that's kind of almost a backwards position, but the best way to be successful online is assume you don't know anything. What I'm talking about more here is the overall strategy, where we build our business based on what our customers tell us they want.
Hi, it's Michael Senoff with HardToFindSeminars.com. Thanks for watching this video. You know, many of my interviews last 30 minutes, 40 minutes, an hour, sometimes even up to 2.5 hours long. They're actual mini-seminars, and you've just listened to a short sample of just one of over 117 hours of exciting, hard-hitting, mind-blowing interviews on how to make money in direct mail, advertising, copywriting. I assure you, there is not a resource anywhere anywhere on the internet or on the planet that comes close to the free information I provide at hardtofindseminars.com. So go right now to hardtofindseminars.com and you'll have free access to 117 hours of audio interviews with typed word-for-word downloadable transcripts and downloadable MP3 files. Please browse some more of the videos or go right directly to hardtofindseminars.com. Thanks for watching.